目前许多人认为是 OpenAI 可以马上取代很多工作，后来现在大家说 AI 的概念已经泡沫化掉，真正的实情是 OpenAI 所写出来的 ChatGPT， 它离可以接近更正确的 professional， 就是更正确的整个智慧系统，还需要数年的时间。而在这数年时间，即使达到了时刻，它不可能是没有人就可以完成的。它很可能是让你本来你要花非常多的精神才可以做出来的很多工作，你可以减少这样的一个人力，就好像我们过去电脑取代了打字机，然后帮你储存了很多资料，你不需要放在资料库，然后找一个人去管理资料库，然后有一个大图书馆，然后后面的资料图书馆里头大家去翻资料翻得一塌糊涂，你光在电脑 file 里头就可以找到资料。这是那个年代的人工智慧，如果你用这个角度来看，一样的未来的 ChatGPT 呢，它很可能就是帮助一个人，比如说帮助一个医生，当他要查出一件事情的时候，他可以有更快的一个方法，可以把相关的一些重要的学术论文很快的它整合出一个各方辩论不同的东西，而不是只是 Google 搜寻，它要重新的去看，不只是如此。所以 ChatGPT 到现在为止它要智慧化到一个程度，到目前为止还没有做到专业化。那么这次 OpenAI 的年轻创办人 Altman， 大家当然喜欢年轻的，可是忽略另外一个人，他是 Google DeepMind， 就是深度学习，人们称他叫 Google 大脑之父，他也是这个 OpenAI Altman 的老师，哈，他叫吴文达，以前是 Stanford 教授。他们两个人都来台湾，还有一个是李杰，三个人都来了台湾。那他们谈到了相关很多的问题，其中吴文达特别也接受了《文献世界日报》记者沈千巧的专访。他的专访里头特别提到了一件我刚才所谈到的事情：你怎么面对 ChatGPT， 怎么看待 ChatGPT， 以及将来如何使用 ChatGPT， 就是你竞争力的开始。
Artificial superintelligence, humanity's last invention.
No reason to be scared.
人工超级智慧 ASI 一套知识总量大于人类，有能力超越人类大脑，但尚未实现仅存在电影情节的 AI 系统。人工通用智慧 AGI 一套如火如荼发展当中，具自我意识，可协助人类解决问题，甚至规划未来的 AI 系统。这两种所谓强 AI 未来会不会全面取代人类主宰世界？放逐世界最适合的作答者之一，9月25号如约而至来到台北南港展览馆七楼，藏身在力邀他第三度访台的永龄基金会创办人郭台铭和自家研究团队台艺主管 Mark Chen 之间的娇小人物，戏骨当红 AI 鬼才，知名人工智慧实验室 OpenAI 创办人 ChatGPT 之父 Sam Altman。
I think the AI revolution is going to be a massively transformative and positively transformative thing. You know, humans through every technological revolution.I've always worried about what the jobs are going to be like and what we're all going to have to do. And it turns out that human desire for new things and creativity is pretty limitless. And so we're going to find wonderful things to do. And what we're seeing with ChatGPT is people just use these AI tools to do more and do better. And they can take their ideas and bring them to life even faster. And it very much is an amplifier of human ingenuity and will, and I think it's, although always a little scary when the ground shakes, where we're headed is just probably much better than any of us can imagine. We will all have tons to do, and we'll look back at this time as a sort of very barbaric age, and we won't believe how much better it's gotten. I think the rate of change will be fast. I don't think AGI is decades away, although it mostly depends on how fast Mark's team makes progress, but I think it'll be pretty quick.
GPT-4 is the latest AI system from OpenAI.
GPT-4 is incredibly advanced and sophisticated. For example, it can tell us that if the strings in this image were cut, the balloons would fly away.
GPT-4 从 ChatGPT 演化而来，更能贴近现实生活的回答人类问题，甚至以合理逻辑判读看懂图片。当协作性创造力更强大下，是 OpenAI 麾下目前最可能朝向实现 AGI 的一套 AI 系统。在永龄基金会举办的 AI 大师论坛上，奥特曼诉说着个人对 AI 产业未来的看好。他对现阶段社会大众评价 AI 站在天平两端，正反极都有，甚至也认为 发展根本不够纯熟的嗤之以鼻，但他说 AI 对他而言一如当年初问世时的 iPhone， 惊艳世人之余也具备了能结合创意狂热与商机的庞大潜力，是可随时间进化革新同时滋养其他产业的变革性科技。但奥特曼不会言，想倾力发展 AI 代价就是燃烧大笔金钱，他也坦诚这的确是 OpenAI 从非盈利转向盈利的最大理由。
What people were already doing today, you know, GPT-4, ChatGPT as it is today, when we look back at it, we're already embarrassed by it. Everybody's going to be embarrassed. You know, when you like got that first iPhone, you thought it was really cool, but now if you look back at it, those like pixels are each like this big and just didn't hold up that well. But it still pointed to something amazing. And now we have these like supercomputers in our pockets. Even in that iPhone 1 era that we're in now, seeing the creativity of people around the world,the enthusiasm for where it's going to go, the businesses people are building, the way they're transforming their workflows, that was all amazing. It was interesting to see how different things are in different cultures in different ways, but the enthusiasm was pretty remarkable. Some areas that I'm particularly excited about are education, healthcare, personal productivity tools, like what we see people do using these coding tools, that's been amazing. I think those will all be great.And then on the company structure side, so we started as a nonprofit. We knew that training these systems were going to be expensive, but we had no idea how expensive. And when it became clear to us that we were eventually going to have to spend hundreds of billions of dollars on building out infrastructure if we wanted to get to our goal, we knew that the nonprofit structure we started with wasn't quite going to work. But the reasons that we started with the nonprofit structure were still super important. We wanted to get the incentives right. We wanted a way to sort ofreturn the benefits and the governance of this technology to society as a whole. Wouldn't make sense for like one company to own.
论坛当天与会嘉宾中，其实有对 AI 师徒组合大师炉边论坛环节中相邻奥特曼而坐的另一位华裔面孔，是在2011年开启 Google 大脑研究，用深度学习推动人工智慧技术革新。奥特曼辍学史丹佛大学前，大一时期曾进入其实验室拜师学习 AI 的吴恩达博士。面对 AI 可能对人类带来破坏式创新，谈到21年前 AI 打败世界棋王的经典一役，师徒有趣的上演了意见相左的一幕。奥特曼认为 AI 即便具备超强能力，但终究不是真人，不可能抹灭人类对彼此的好奇和想要探究的心，世界还是会继续以人为本的生活实验运转下去。吴恩达则对 AI 解锁能力有所保留，直言 AI 尽管总能让人类惊喜，但依然存在无法完成的任务。
Today of course can't do most things. The question I think that's more interesting is what won't it be able to do in 5 years or 10 years or something like that? And there's a lot of things in that category. One thing that I think is particularly important is humans really care about what other humans do. Humans also tend to really have a good intuition for what other humans want. But, you know, when AI beatGary Kasparov in chess, one of the first times like AI became known as a thing, this was a long time ago, it was the system called Deep Blue. You can go back and read the news articles and they said like, well, you know, this is it. No one is ever going to play chess again. This thing is done. Fast forward to today, chess has never been more popular. It's also very popular to watch. No one, or not many people, watch like two AIs play against each other. We tend not to care about that.You know, we also really care if people are using AI to cheat, but there's this thing where like humans are interested in other humans in all sorts of ways. And I don't expect that to change no matter how good AI gets.
After Garry Kasparov lost to Deep Blue, I stopped playing chess. I don't know. I think technology is amazing. It's hard to predict exactly where it will go. I think that,There are a lot of things that are still fundamental laws of physics. Humans can't break them. AI also can't break the laws of physics. And I think digital intelligences are very different than biological intelligences. But no matter how intelligent something is, some things are still hard. I think digital intelligences do amazing things. They do a lot. But I think that, like cure cancer, I just don't know even if with AI, you know, some fantastic intelligence, how easy will that be? Can't say that is very
exciting. 温达的论点呼应了论坛开始前接受文献的《世界周报》专访时温柔而坚定的说法。他谈到多数人开口闭口害怕 AI 失控发展灭绝人类的深层恐惧，认为即便单一领域也牵涉众多任务，如新闻采访从背景研究到撰稿校对，记者一手包办；如影像诊断学也不可能只靠判读 X 光片就能成事。但 AI 确实可以介入单一专业，协助一两样任务分工，全数交给 AI。目前技术尚未发展到这个阶段。吴恩达再三强调，灭绝论言过其实。他特别点名美国政坛近来针对 AI 立法的相关讨论，一度上纲到禁止使用核武，认为这种缺乏从企业营运面制定立法的政策思考令人遗憾。
I think it's unfortunate that in the U.S. there has been work.To want legislation to prevent AI from accessing nuclear weapons. And clearly, no one wants AI to access nuclear weapons. But time spent debating that, which is a non-issue, is time that regulators are not spending, instead debating more substantive things like how can we get AI companies to be more transparent? How can we mitigate bias? Where does liability fall? And so I find that the discussions of AI extinction risk has been a huge distraction.But it's been, I think some, there are definitely companies that would rather regulators worry about nuclear weapons and extinction risk rather than pass less convenient laws that will be more impactful for protecting people but could be less beneficial to the companies.
回到论坛上 ，AI 大师们的思想碰撞有着一致脉络，必须把 AI 当作技术革新的驱动引擎，而不是一味抗拒。在有人工智慧相伴的这个时代，在等待通用人工智慧实现成真的乌托邦世界里 ，AI 全面改变且提升人类生活的那一天终会到来。